So after narrowly missing out on the win at Melbourne, Freddie was in a surprisingly cheerful mood. The fact that Hamilton and Rosberg both crashed out has already lifted a lot of weight off his shoulders. But now the focus turns to Bahrain, where Freddie won last season. As ever, he's aiming to take the win. But first, it is time for qualifying. Let's get into the report. As darkness ascended, the fight for pole position was about to begin, with the battle between Mercedes and Ferrari set to be closer than ever. Sauber had a miserable day, with Ericsson and Nasr taking up the back row. On the other hand, Manor had an exceptional day with 15th and 16th, Pascal Wehrlein the quicker of the two drivers. McLaren Honda also struggled under the floodlights, as both cars were only narrowly quicker than the two Saubers. Gutierrez outqualified teammate Grosjean for the second consecutive race, while Brit Jolyon Palmer further stamped his authority on teammate Kevin Magnussen. Red Bull didn't fare much better in qualifying, with Ricciardo outside the top 10. The surprise of the session was the pace of Nico Hülkenberg, who excelled around the Bahrain International Circuit. Perez qualified 10th. Dutchman Verstappen had a much better day after securing 8th, as he was aiming to put behind the disappointment of Melbourne. Valtteri Bottas was best at the rest in 5th, with Massa a further 2 positions back. Only 8 hundredths of a second separated Ferrari and Mercedes, but it was Lewis Hamilton who once again came out on top, with Sebastian Vettel and Nico Rosberg setting identical times. Freddie Gray still 4th position. So we've learned that Mercedes and Ferrari are very evenly matched, which sets us up for an incredibly tense battle to the checkered flag. Let's get in to the Bahrain Grand Prix.
Okay, we won here last season, let's repeat that. Come on!
So indeed, guys, we won the race last year. We can quite easily do that this year from 4th on the grid. A much improved qualifying this time round, as the lights are out here for the Bahrain Grand Prix, round 2 of this 2016 season. We've gotten off to a very good start in comparison to Vettel ahead of us. We're getting slipstream off him as we head down into turn 1 now, breaking a little bit early, just being that slight bit too cautious perhaps, as we do head now into turn 2, and we've gained so many positions here. Now at the expense of Lewis Hamilton and Mercedes, what a start this has been so far, guys. We were going quite cautious into turn 1, but so were the AI, and we really took advantage of that. We couldn't even get into the lead here, guys. We could maybe even overtake Sebastian Vettel up the inside. Indeed, we have done. Up the inside of turn 3, what a move that is, and we are now leading the Bahrain Grand Prix under floodlights here. Vettel in 2nd, Hamilton 3rd, Valtteri Bottas in 4th, I believe all that might even be Felipe Massa, probably is Bottas at this moment in time. I doubt Massa's made that good of a start, but now onto lap 2. At the moment we have locked our tyres a little bit, and Vettel is slowly catching up. It's one lap to go now until the DRS is enabled, so that's when Vettel, Hamilton and guys like that will be able to catch up to us, make potential overtaking manoeuvres, but we have strangely lost an end plate on our front wing over absolutely nothing. If you have a look at the replay here, I have no idea what caused this, but we've lost part of our end plate. Now we're going to have to make an extended pit stop for our first scheduled stop of the day, which is absolutely stupid. And as a result, Sebastian Vettel's caught up dramatically here. He's going to the outside on the straight, really bearing down. It's actually already slipstreamed his way past, obviously with the DRS as well. There is Lewis Hamilton. We're going to try and cut him off heading into turn 1. We'll be able to defend that around the outside. He's in fact set the fast lap. So Hamilton and Vettel currently really on the pace at the moment in comparison to ourselves. That bit of front wing damage has really affected us quite severely, really getting quite a lot of understeer into the sort of low speed corner, especially the last corner anyway, where we're really struggling to get a very good exit out of the corner. But now looking at a replay of us defending Lewis Hamilton, Freddie doing very well there, great defensive driving, just opening up enough space around the outside. He managed to get the grip out the corner and he remains in P2 for now, behind obviously his teammate Sebastian Vettel. He will have DRS on this lap by the looks of it. Hamilton seems just as close behind, so he's also going to have to watch his mirrors for Lewis Hamilton as well as Sebastian Vettel in front. He's going to have to focus on him as much as possible as we now head into turn 1, getting at such great speeds here, going into turn 1 up the inside of Sebastian Vettel. We pulled it off up the inside, up into the lead of the Grand Prix. Constant position changes so far at the start of this Bahrain Grand Prix. A lot of action so far.
Brilliant driving there, Freddie. Seb also has some front wing damage.
So it actually sounds as if Sebastian Vettel also has front wing damage. They're very strange there. I'm not sure how Vettel picked up that damage. Maybe it was from the start of the race, which is interesting to say these. Obviously, the cars are very bunched up at the start, and a lot of cars actually pitted in at the end of lap 1. Obviously, the start with a realistic damage mod, it's hard not to lose your front wing, especially at a turn 1 like Bahrain, where it's really so tight and twisty. Very, very narrow, and it's really hard to keep your car intact. However, we do now have Sebastian Vettel 4 tenths behind us. He's actually going to go to the outside. We're going to force him to go to the outside line here. can Vettel pull it off around the outside of turn one? Not quite. We defend it very well once again, however, running out very, very wide on turn one, perhaps breaking that little bit too late there in desperation of defending from our teammate. And Vettel has made the move back around the outside. Brilliant exit Vettel must have got there. Supreme traction. We're going to try and go back up the inside now, but Vettel has pretty much got the position covered for now, so we're going to have to try and overtake him on the next DRS straight. But honestly, guys, this is just the lead has changed so much so far in this Grand Prix, and I think it's just really just the case of this first stint. We're all on similar tyres at the moment, but I do believe that the next stint will be very interesting, to say the least, because I think we're all going to go on different strategies. Me, Vettel, and also Lewis Hamilton. We're just going to have to wait and find out. I think it's going to be a couple of laps until the first scheduled pit stop. As Freddie makes complete hash the final corner, Lewis Hamilton is going to be all over him, bearing down on him now, pulling along to the inside. Freddie, what's he going to do here? He has the DRS from Sebastian Vettel, his teammate. He's going to move to the inside now. Could he even dive it down the inside of Lewis Hamilton going into turn one? Can we do it here? Yes, we have. Just about. What a move there. Brilliant composure once again from Freddie. Really did not look likely that he'd be able to pull off that move, but he has done it.
Your overtakes have been top-notch so far. You're really putting on a good show for the crowd, mate.
And indeed he is putting on a great show today, Freddie Gray, as you can see, making the move back up the inside of Lewis Hamilton. Now onto lap 8. It's going to be very interesting now because we are approaching the first round of pit stops. Who is going to pit in first? And it actually just seemed to be Lewis Hamilton in the Mercedes. So Lewis Hamilton is going to go for an undercut here. Very, very interesting.
Okay, box this lap. We're going to fit another set of options.
So we are pitting in at the end of this lap for another set of option tyres. The interesting thing is now, will Lewis Hamilton also pit in for option tyres, or will he be on the primes? Because if that's the case, guys, we desperately need to get this overcut done here on Lewis Hamilton, our fellow rival. But now we are have the DRS on our teammate here, Sebastian Vettel. Are we going to make the move stick and outbreak him here up the inside? And we have overtaken Sebastian Vettel. A very nice, tidy move there on our German teammate. But now the attention turns to Freddie's first pit stop of the day. Obviously, we have to change our front wing off the damage we suffered on lap 2. Looking at the radar there, definitely do have to change our front wing a little bit. And Sebastian Vettel obviously staying out there extra laps. So he's going for a 2-lap overcut here on Lewis Hamilton. Pretty crazy. But now we have Bottas and Rosberg following us in. Let's hope they didn't hold us up too much, especially Valtteri Bottas. But I don't think they will due to the front wing change that we're having. So where will Lewis Hamilton be? That is the main question now. It's going to be very, very close between Freddie and Lewis Hamilton. Once again, it looks like it's going to be a battle between those two come the end of this Bahrain Grand Prix. Very reminiscent of Season 2. Hopefully we can repeat that, what happened in Season 2, with another race. We're going to have to find out, where is Lewis Hamilton now? We're going to go back on board with Freddie, and he is just ahead, literally just. Actually, a lot closer than Freddie and the Ferrari team were actually thinking. So, incredibly, incredibly close.
Hamilton is on prime, so we need to pass him. I repeat, we need to pass him.
So real, real concern here from the Ferrari team. Lewis Hamilton is on the medium tyre and we need to get past him and try and increase the gap as quickly as possible. We quite clearly have the pace over him at the moment, looking to perhaps make a move on the DRS straight, maybe even before that. If that happens, Lewis Hamilton basically getting out of our way. Thank you very much. Freddie is now up into P2, obviously behind Sebastian Vettel, who is yet to pit. But now looking at the replay of our move on Lewis Hamilton, very, very minimal contact was made. In fact, probably no contact whatsoever. Hamilton just simply getting out of the way. But I'm not complaining. Freddie is not complaining at all. This is where it matters now on the DRS straight. Where is our teammate Sebastian Vettel? There is the yellow dot on the minimap. And we have absolutely done him there. Completely. Look at that. Such a huge undercut we got there on our teammate Sebastian Vettel. And he has really has dropped behind. He's dropped behind Lewis Hamilton as well. And I believe Vettel is also on the prime tyres. So running a very similar strategy to Lewis Hamilton. Alternating strategies, in fact, in the Ferrari garage, which may get a little bit interesting towards the end of this Grand Prix. But the main job now is to pull away from Lewis Hamilton and Sebastian Vettel.
Okay, Freddie, it's now important that we now increase the gap to Seb and Hamilton behind.
Yep, just further reinforcement there for our engineer. It's absolutely crucial that we pull away from Hamilton and Vettel whilst we have these fresh option tyres, the faster compound tyres. We're setting the fast lap at 1 minute 34.3, already pulling away 2.3 seconds ahead of Lewis Hamilton. Sebastian Vettel is actually not that far behind Lewis Hamilton, so perhaps Vettel could make the move up into P2. It would be great to get a 1-2 today for the team, but interestingly, on lap 16, we're just running our own race here for these last few laps. Literally nothing has happened. We've just caught up to the back markers, and the safety car has been deployed thanks to a retirement for Rio Haryanto, I can confirm. So this is going to make things very interesting, because we weren't due to pit in again until lap 19, and the safety car will be out until around lap 18, lap 19, so we might have to change the strategy up a little bit here. Now we are on lap 18, I believe this is when the safety car is due into the pits behind. Sebastian Vettel has managed to overtake Lewis Hamilton. I think he just about pulled that off before the safety car was deployed, so very, very interesting. And actually looking at the DNF counter now, we're down to 18 cars. I don't know what's gone on towards the back of the field. So yeah, we just got to focus on this restart, focusing on pulling away from Sebastian Vettel and obviously Lewis Hamilton. But in fact, we make a mistake out of the exit of the penultimate corner, and we're now back down to third. Oh, nice auto spin curbs. Jesus Christ. I do not know what happened there at all. Now, looking at the replay, just getting too much curb, and we have dropped down to third position. What on earth?
Don't worry about the mistake. Just focus on getting Hamilton at the restart.
But guys, do not worry. As you can tell by that team radio message and also the length of this video remaining, this is a pretty thrilling final stint. So just get prepared. Here we go. Sebastian Vettel is about to get this restart underway for the final 10 laps here of this Bahrain Grand Prix. And we are underway now. Green flag resume race. And there are cars behind that are already pitting in for their final stops by the looks of it. That could pay absolute dividends for them coming into this Grand Prix. We've got to wait and find out. But obviously the main focus for Freddie now is to overtake Lewis Hamilton in the restart. We're going to go for the undercut switchback maneuver here. And we have pulled it off around the outside. Hamilton is still there. But Freddie gets the traction and the grip. And what a move that was there. Brilliant, brilliant driving from Freddie Gray. A brilliant, fantastic overtake. And he is now up into P2 behind his teammate Sebastian Vettel, who's obviously still on the prime tyres. We still have the faster tyres at this point, as the wear levels are relatively similar to Vettel and Hamilton. As we now go into the cinematic view, we are right on the back of Sebastian Vettel, bearing down on him. Are we going to try and make a move around the outside? We could perhaps do that here. Yes, we have. We got the grip, and we have made the move just about, or have we? Sebastian Vettel's still there, but we do make the move up the inside, and what an overtake. Brilliant, brilliant stuff once again from Freddie Gray. We've just got to try and pull away as quickly as possible. Now, into the pits we are for our final pit stop of the day. Now, onto the prime tyres for this fast. This is absolutely crucial. This outlap is the most important we've done in a while, to be fair, because this is an incredibly close Grand Prix between ourselves, Sebastian Vettel, and Lewis Hamilton. Incredibly, incredibly close. Doesn't look like we're going to have much traffic to conquer at the moment. The traffic that was obviously packed up behind the safety car is pulled away from us quite a bit. I believe this man ahead of us, I think it's Pascal Wehrlein, because Harry had to retire earlier on. He's a bat mark, so he's going to move out our way without any issue whatsoever. But now, where is Sebastian Vettel? Where is Lewis Hamilton? There is Sebastian Vettel, and we have easily gotten ahead of him by a good 2 or 3 seconds, in fact. So really, really easy stuff in the end for ourselves. But now we are in P7, behind Danica Fiat and the Red Bull in P6, who seems to be really struggling at the moment, going very slowly out of turns 1, 2, and in fact turns 3. We're going to make the move very easy here. Danica Fiat obviously having engine issues of some sort on the approach to turn 4, but now ahead we have 5th placed Esteban Gutierrez in the Haas F1 car, who is obviously yet to pit along with 4 other cars who are ahead of him. Looks like 3 cars are into the pits now, including Gutierrez, Rosberg and Valtteri Bottas.
Perez and Sainz are not pitting again. We must overtake them on track. You can do this, Freddie, come on.
Oh dear. Well, it looks like we may have cocked up slightly here, or Sergio Perez and Carlos Sainz, their race engineers or strategists, have pulled off an absolutely brilliant strategy call for both those drivers. They're currently P1 and P2, but we have been catching them up at a rapid, rapid rate here. There is now 3 laps to go. We have Sebastian Vettel all over us on the option tyres. He is really caught up whilst we've been reeling in Carlos Sainz and Sergio Perez. By the way, just to get out of the way quickly, sorry for Carlos Sainz's name being spelt wrong. It's not really my fault. I'll get it fixed for the next episode, but it doesn't matter now. We are right on the back of the Spanish 21-year-old driver, currently looking to go around the outside perhaps, but Carlos Sainz does block us off. We just got to watch our mirrors more than anything, because for Sebastian Vettel, who is currently on the quicker tyres, it's going to be very, very interesting to see if we can actually conquer Carlos Sainz and Sergio Perez with just 2 laps to go. At the moment, guys, Freddie's tyres are really beginning to go off, even beginning to reach the cliff at this early stage. The prime tyres really did not last up too well. I remember Freddie suffering a very similar problem last season when Lewis Hamilton caused him up at a huge, huge rate towards the end of that Grand Prix last season. And it seems to be happening again with Sebastian Vettel, although we got a much better run this time out of the exit of the final quarter for the first time in this Grand Prix. We got an amazing run here on Carlos Sainz, bearing down on him now. He seems to have DRS on Sergio Perez. We're going to try and dive up the inside of the Toro Rosso driver. Can we pull it off here up the inside? And yes, we have done it. And Sebastian Vettel is also through as well. The Ferraris are charging here under the floodlights in Bahrain. Now, next up is Sergio Perez, who is an absolute expert around Bahrain.
Three laps to go, and Perez is now in striking distance.
Yes, he is indeed now within striking distance. Three laps to go now. Sergio Perez is right up ahead of us, but he is obviously a brilliant, brilliant driver around Bahrain. We've shown it in the past of Perez. 2014, he sealed a podium in real life, so he's going to have to expect a huge challenge here. But look at Sebastian Vettel darting around all over the place behind. Freddie must be so scared to have a four-time world champion right on the back of him as he's trying to pass a Mercedes-powered car in the form of Sergio Perez. His tyres are going off, Freddie, you know, at a huge rate of knots at the moment, and this is really, really putting an awful lot of pressure on Freddie to try and make the move on Sergio Perez. He is right there, you know, he's there for the taking, but Freddie just cannot seem to get the grip or the traction where it really matters. It's going to be very dramatic, very, very tense finish here, guys. It really, really is been an incredible Grand Prix, and it's really just not over yet. But into Turn 1, I know something interesting. Carlos Sainz, you know, the pressure got to him. He went straight on at Turn 1 after sort of being, you know, being in a battle with the two Mercedes drivers of Nico Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton. But now onto the pit straight. We're going to open up the DRS on Sergio Perez. This is now the final lap of the Grand Prix. And look, Lewis Hamilton and Nico Rosberg have now caught up. Literally, Sergio Perez must be absolutely shitting his pants right now as Freddie dives up the inside into the lead of the Grand Prix on the final lap of the Bahrain Grand Prix. What a move that was. Perez is still there, though. He's got brilliant traction out of the exit, along with Sebastian Vettel as well. How is Perez going to fare here? He appears to back off on his Freddie goes incredibly wide into Turn 3, getting all sorts of bubbles on his tyres. That is not what he wants at this moment in time. And I believe Mercedes behind has lost their front wing. I think that's Nico Rosberg who's holding up Lewis Hamilton. Lewis Hamilton, I think, is going to get through sometime soon. But now Perez is under pressure from Sebastian Vettel. But there's still another DRS straight to go, guys. And Freddie has completely lost the tyres, completely lost the brakes, just lost everything at the moment. And Perez is right on the back of him. Just so much going on at the moment on this final lap of the Bahrain Grand Prix. Just imagine if it's this tense in the actual real life Grand Prix. I bloody well hope so. But here is Perez. He's got an amazing run out of turn line. He could even retake the lead here, and he has. Sergio Perez in the Force India. Who would have thought? And now Sebastian Vettel is also trying to go for it as well on Freddie Gray. But he's made the move. He's dived it back up the inside into the lead of the Grand Prix. Once again, Perez is still there though on the inside. Perez battling hard. He eventually prevails and backs off. But that now allows Sebastian Vettel to go round the outside, and it couldn't be a 1-2 for the team. Unbelievable scenes here in the Bahrain under the floodlights in the darkness. I cannot believe what I have just seen. Freddie Gray taking the win, you know, in the lead of the Grand Prix on two different occasions on this final lap. I'm just lost for words right now, guys. We're going to come across the line for our first win of the season in a dramatic Bahrain Grand Prix. Get in there!
Oh yes, get in there. We made that one difficult for ourselves, but it's a dramatic 1-2 for the team. Come on.
I cannot believe that. What a race we have seen so far, guys. If you did enjoy this video, if you enjoyed that race, if you thought that was entertaining, be sure to leave a like and a comment down below. Oh my goodness me, what a race we have seen today at Bahrain. Let's hope for many more like this in the real life season and obviously in this career mode. As you can see, Sergio Perez just about finishing off Lewis Hamilton for the final podium position. Hamilton himself picking up fourth. Fifth place was Felipe Massa. Sixth place was Max Verstappen, putting behind him the disappointment of Melbourne with an absolutely exceptional result. Rosberg off losing his front wing on the final lap in seventh. Hülkenberg eighth. Carlos Sainz in ninth position. And Daniel Ricciardo rounding off the points here at the Bahrain Grand Prix. And obviously, four DNFs in the form of Felipe Massa, Kevin Magnussen, Jenson Button, and Rio Haryanto, guys. What a race. Let's take a look at the championship standings. And in the Drivers' Championship, Freddie Gray takes a huge lead, 8 points back to Felipe Massa. And obviously, this is the first race of the season where Vettel, Hamilton, and the likes of Rosberg have actually scored points. So Freddie, you know, has quite a large lead at the moment by the looks of it. But tracks coming up such as China, Spain, Monaco, and even Russia, he's not the greatest around. So I'm expecting Freddie to drop points to those guys in the upcoming races. Let's hope that doesn't happen, but it is more than possible. Palmer still in fourth. Vettel jumps all the way up into third, back to his second place. Perez scoring his first points of the season with fifth. And in fact, his first finish of the season. But honestly, what a race for him. Brilliant, brilliant driving. Same score he said for Carlos Sainz. Same, he cracked under pressure and lost it at Turn 1, outbreaking himself. Lewis Hamilton in seventh in the Drivers' Championship with Button 8. Alonso still in ninth. Verstappen jumped all the way up to 10th, and Rosberg jumped up into 11th for Mercedes after losing his front wing on the final lap. Just so much going on, guys, and it really, really was a very tense Grand Prix. And obviously in the constructors, we are leading by quite a long way. Our Ferrari 61 points back to Williams with 35. Toro now level with McLaren in third with both 20 points. Force India in fifth with 19. This is the first race that Force India actually scored points this season. They've already jumped ahead of Mercedes, who scored their first points this race. So brilliant, brilliant job from Force India. Really do have a good car this year. Renault 7th, Haas 8th, Red Bull 9th, Sauber in 10th, and Manor in 11th place. A very difficult start for Red Bull, in fact, but I'm sure they'll pick themselves up in future Grand Prix. What a race it has been today, guys. I will see you next time for China. Bye-bye.